very excited about our new website. It's much more interactive, it's a lot easier to use, and all the pages are flexible and easy to adapt to our different editors. Some of our new features include a scrolling slideshow on the front page that allows us to feature larger photos, allows us to feature more stories, and allows us to put up more content.
The opinion section is one of the most well-read sections of the Chronicle, so when we were designing this new site, we had this in mind. We added an opinion box at the bottom of the opinion page that makes it easier to find the articles that your favorite columnists have written.
Our sports page has room for a large photo. Our sports photos are some of the best that we have, so we wanted to feature that prominently on that page. While in contrast, our recent page has different sections for reviews, for features, for different things regarding music, for a bar for multimedia. And the idea is to give a lot of the editors really like the flexibility to design the pages they see fit and the room to update their pages accordingly.
We have a new breaking news box, so if it's easy for the editors to post new stuff, then there's a place for readers to read about breaking news.
The idea is to create as many real-time opportunities for the site as possible, so you're seeing the news when it happens.
One of the major philosophies behind design is that we wanted to make something that looked beautiful, but organized and readable at the same time.
And that took a lot of effort because when you look at most newspaper websites like New York Times or other college newspapers, you know, they mostly focus on the readability aspect. And the way they accomplish that is by, you know, using gray lines to divide various content. We wanted to try something new and beyond that. So instead of taking design cues from the likes of existing newspaper websites, like we did in the past with our current website, we instead chose to look at websites like Apple, Google Plus, some of the newer websites that are experimenting with new types of design.
We've put a lot of attention into how the user will navigate and experience a website. There's really minor details like, you know, the drop shadows on the boxes, the fact that there's a blue highlight when you hover over article boxes, the fact that instead of having to click on the article, you can click on any part of the box that contains it. So we just wanted to do every little thing we can to make navigating the site as enjoyable and as easy of a process as possible.
The new site will improve the way users communicate with one another. We've integrated a third-party commenting system called Discuss that gives you the option to use your Twitter and Facebook accounts. Other cool features include friend comments, the ability to upvote other people's comments, and email notifications that lets you know when someone replies to something you wrote.
The idea is to really create more community and to create more basis for discussion and to allow more interaction between our users with each other and as well as their friends so they can share content.
We knew that as news websites progressed, we're going to be pulling sources and news items from all type of websites like Facebook, like Twitter, blogs. So we really wanted to create a design that easily facilitates that, where the user doesn't get the sense that, you know, they're reading content from multiple sources. We wanted to present this cohesive, unified view of all the content that we're presenting.
It's a great thing that the new Chronicle website is going to be deployed in the cloud. It makes it so that you're always using the most recent technology, the most recent software. You won't have to host the servers yourself, which would mean keeping them up to date, making sure that they're always on. It'll allow developers that are making changes to the back end of the Chronicle website to make those changes. Even if they were studying in Shanghai or London, they could make the changes in the cloud. It'll make sure that when new technologies are unrolled, either faster servers or faster networks, everybody that's using the services, both developers and your readers, will get the best service right away.
We put a lot of effort into making the Chronicle easier to read on your mobile devices. Instead of going with the mobile app, we decided to go with the mobile site. So if you like to get your news from places like Twitter or Facebook, and you can just click on our links and you're automatically redirected to our mobile site, which is a lot easier to read.
There
was a huge difference in the development process from our old site to our new site. The biggest one being that the old site was essentially developed by one person from feedback from the rest of the staff, while our current site, we've had over a dozen Nuke students contribute to the code base that's back in the website.
And that is very significant because, you know, the Chronicle Online team grew from essentially 1 to 2 students to over 30, and there's a wide range of experience and talent. And, you know, we have freshmen who, you know, just started taking computer science classes, to seniors who will be working at major tech companies as, you know, software engineers and project managers.
Since the development was all done by Duke students, Duke undergrads, who are kind of doing it both because of the passion they have for the Chronicle and because of the passion they have for new technology, I think it's a great thing. It's a hard thing. These guys have put in, and maybe there's some girls too, but my guess is it's mostly guys these days, hundreds and hundreds of hours learning, using techniques that they've used, that they've learned outside of the classroom, but that we started them on. So seeing the students kind of take off and go, maybe it's a great thing.
We definitely used things we learned in our computer science classes, like caching, memorization, programming, and API. But a lot of the computer science curriculum doesn't focus on web development for one thing. So we kind of were on our own, had to use the internet and the open source community to kind of figure out what the best way to build out this technology was.
One of our more ambitious goals is to completely release the source code that's behind our website to the general public so that anybody can, you know, read the code, borrow ideas, and even contribute to the code. We think this will be very important going forward, where, you know, instead of just depending on the 20 to 30 students that we have, we're going to be opening up the system to a much wider range of, you know, talented people.
You get the newest, coolest, greatest technology. It's all open source, so it's all something that you can contribute back to, so you're also being part of the community as well as using it. It's where a lot of the great development is happening today.
There's a bright future for the website, and there will definitely be a lot of new changes and new features in the pipeline.
I think we're all really excited to bring you the next generation of online news.